Hello, I'm Mike, and last week OpenAI introduced their GPT-4o image generation via their API. That means using AI coding tools, you can actually make a useful app that maybe people are willing to pay for. Let's find out how to do it. Now, in this video, there's a caveat. I'll be using open source AI tools like Zed AI, Tabby AI, and also Void. Yes, that's right, the open source AI code editor. We're heading into the void. So let's dive in and test all of these great tools in partnership with Zapier. Now, for this video, we'll go straight from downloading to find out exactly how easy it is to download. And with Zed, it seems pretty easy. I just download to my Mac and there we go. We've got it ready to install. And yes, it seems to be as simple as dragging and dropping the icon into my applications folder. With that done, we'll fire up Zed for the first time and it looks really super simple. Now, I'm guessing this icon up here, the AI thing, can do something for me. No language model configured. So let's go ahead and configure. And it's asking for Amazon Bedrock keys, Anthropic keys. We've got all kinds of keys, any kind of thing, even Ollama. So you can do this locally and OpenAI as well. So just to give it the best chance, we'll set it up with Claude from Anthropic. Super duper simple. I've just generated a key and I'm going to paste it in here. And hopefully, yes, API key is configured. So I should now be able to use the latest Claude models to code inside Zed, which is completely free and open source. Let's close this down and start a new chat. Okay, it seems to say no LLM provider selected. I'll go back to configure providers and let's try open a new chat from the Anthropic window. Now we've got a new chat and this does seem to be configured with some kind of Claude model, which has a 200,000 token context window, but I don't know which model. Oh yes, it's down here, Claude 3.7 Sonnet. And I guess, yes, I can switch and choose any of the Anthropic models. This is pretty cool. All right, now we've figured that out, let's stick with Claude 3.7 Sonnet and paste in my prompt. Now, first I'll see if I can paste in this prompt, create a simple web app that allows you to upload a photo, select from presets like cartoon, abstract, voxel, or professional photo, then create an image from the photo using the GPT Image 1 model from OpenAI's Image Generation API. And I've also put in the API docs as a link. I'm hoping Zed can handle links, but if not, we can pivot. So now I just need to click send, which is right down in the bottom corner. You can see it over here. Let's click send and see what happens. Okay, cool. This is really good. It's planning out the project structure already. It's writing some code. And I'm just wondering if it's going to turn this from chat code into code that appears over here. Okay, I've started a new chat. This is my original chat in the history, but I discovered a couple of things along the way. First of all, there doesn't seem to be a composer feature like you'd get in Cursor or Windsurf or Lovable. So I'm going to have to instruct this and then copy and paste the code into separate files. Okay, this prompt is the same, but I put the API docs in the actual prompt here and I'm going to try it one more time and this time come up with the code. And when it comes up, I'm going to copy and paste this into new files. Okay, cool, that's done. I've got an index, I've got styles, and I've got a bit of JavaScript, I guess, to do the behind the scenes stuff. And I've got instructions on how to use. Just open the index.html file. So let's give it a go. Here's the index file. And do you know what? This is really good. Image transformer didn't take me long. Sad that there's no composer in Zed, but I can drop an image in here. So let's give it a go with an image of myself that I've downloaded. There it is. And it gives me the ability to select styles. So I can have cartoon, abstract, professional, so many different options. I'm going to go for cartoon. And now it gives me the opportunity to enter an OpenAI API key. Now, I could, of course, hard code this or put this into the code, but I love the fact that it's actually on the front end for me to use as I wish. Okie dokie, I'll just whack in a temporary key that I've generated there. Love the fact that it doesn't show the key as well. And let's click generate image. Error, unknown parameter, image. Oh dear. That's good because now we get to try and fix a bug inside Zed. Enter this error here and see what happens when I send it to Zed's assistant. Okay, interestingly enough, it's generated the code that should fix this, but I'm guessing I have to copy and paste it to the correct part of script.js, which is not optimal. So maybe I'll try again by clicking the little inline assist on my script.js file, and I'll type into my assistant here what the error is. Okay, wow. Okay, it's going through and it's editing this file. It's doing it really rather quickly as well. I hope it's making the changes required to make my AI image generator work. Well, there we go. All the changes seem to have been made and we can see the diff here. And I'm guessing if I go here and click tick, yes, it applies those changes. And then Command S on my Mac to save it. Let's try again. Paste in that OpenAI API key. Generate image. Whoa, okay. Transforming your image. Is this going to work? Oh, yes. Wow. Okay. That's interesting. It took a little moment, but it seems to have done what I asked for. A little bit of messing up on the logo there, but it looks pretty cool. I wonder if I can roll again for a voxel version of me and click generate image again. And yes, here we have it. Although it has replaced my previous image, that's a pretty good voxel style image of me sitting down compared to the original. So we can tell that this is definitely using the latest GPT-4o image generation model via the API, which is good. And it didn't take me too long to code inside Zed. So I want to add persistence, and I love using AI to do all the work. Add persistence by saving the images to a Zapier table. Tell me the fields I'll need in my Zapier table for this to work. And then we can run this with the assistant. And here we go. It's actually given me some great ideas. I think I'll grab a few of these and set up my table. Over here in Zapier, let's create a table. We'll call it AI images, create that table. Now we'll add the fields, image ID, image URL, creation date, and a field for saving the prompt. So now we have those four fields. We can set this up over in Zed and keep the persistence going over here inside Zapier. To make this easy to do, I'll click the Zaps icon and I'll create a new Zap that links to this table. And I'm going to choose to bring data in. Now you'll see it's already added the create record part of the Zap. So I just need to make the trigger. And this is going to be really simple. We'll use a webhook. Here's the webhook I need to use. Let's copy that. And this really is a very simple Zap. It's already named AI Images Zap 1. Okay, now that's set up in Zapier, taking inspiration from my chat here. I've got the four fields I need. So I'm going to go ahead and edit this document inline using the edit inline magic icon there, inline assist. And we'll just say when an AI image is generated, send the four data points to the Zapier webhook. And there are those data points. We hit enter and immediately the AI is running through this whole file, editing and looking over everything it needs to do. So far, it hasn't made any changes, but when it gets here, it's inserting all the functions needed to call up Zapier, and you can see everything is put in exactly where it needs to be. And boom, this is the part of the code that calls the Zapier webhook, so we're all good. Let's click tick and retry. Okay, now the Zap is published. Let's generate an abstract image of me. Yeah, that's not too bad at all. Let's look at the history. Now we can see from our lovely run, we've got lots of data here that we can hook into our Zapier table. So under the configuration of Zapier tables, I'll simply hook in all of the fields, /, and then image ID, /, and then image URL, /, and creation date, and prompt. Then we'll click continue and we'll test the step. Now we'll check in with that Zapier table, and there's the image ID, URL, creation date, and even the prompt that we use to create that image. And we can keep continuously doing this. Every time we generate an image, it's now automatically saved into a Zapier table. Things I like about this open source AI code editor is it's very easy and simplistic to navigate around. It really does just focus on the files that you're working on. It's got this great inline assistant where you can simply load the assistant inline and tell it what you want to change. So make this better and things like that. And we can edit right directly inside our code. We've got an assistant over here that seems to give you ideas and give you all the code. But unlike, say, Cursor, it doesn't have a Cursor composer that can actually create all the files you suggest, unless I'm missing that on first glance. And remember, I'm as new to these editors as you are. And you can also configure the inline chat to work with pretty much any AI assistant, even local AI assistants, so that you can really code with a free and open source editor. It's not going to cost you anything apart from your API credits or your GPU cycles if you're local. All in all, I think Zed is pretty solid, and it's great if you want a simplistic AI coding editor. Like and subscribe if you're enjoying the video so far. Let's get on to the second open source AI coding editor. Let's check out Tabby for secure, flexible, and transparent AI coding. And I love the icon. It's very nice indeed. Okay, I can view a live demo or I can get started. So let's click get started. This takes me to some documents about Tabby. Telling me what is Tabby. There are installation docs. Let's see. Okay. This is rather more complex than Zed because we can do Docker, Docker Compose, Homebrew on the Mac. We've got Linux and Windows install instructions. You definitely need to be a little more techie to get Tabby working. So let's test it out. And I'm going to stick with simplicity to start with. I suppose Docker would be for power users, but let's go for Homebrew. And indeed, it says it's limited on Mac M1 and M2 and likely sufficient only for individual usage. So if you want power stuff, yeah, the Docker way is the way to go. But seemingly it's only two commands to get it running on a Mac. So let's copy this command. Oh, there we go. I fired up my Mac's terminal app, brew install Tabby. Whoa, That seems to be done. So all I need to do now is copy this second command, and you'll notice inside this command, it's already suggesting the models that should be used and the chat model and everything else, and that it's running on Metal. Can you see that? It's actually downloading models to use. It's 1 gigabyte in total. I'm not expecting big things from this model, by the way. Ah, yes. Okay, we've got Tabby listening live at 0.0.0:8080. There we go. So we've typed in the URL here and, oh, okay, welcome. Your Tabby server is live and ready to use. Let's click start. Okay, I need to create an account to get started. Okay, we've got something very much like GitHub with your activity over the year, acceptance rate, completions and chats, and a nice avatar that I'm sure you can customize, endpoint. We've got tokens, so this can be accessed via API. It's all very techie. So I'm going to make this bigger now. We don't really need the command line. And it just says ask anything. So I'll paste in the same prompt I just used with Zed to try and create my GPT-4o image generator. Nice to also note we can attach documents if needed for reference. And it does say that it's in beta, so beware, anything could happen. So here's the same prompt. Now I'm pasting in the docs rather than giving a URL because I'm not sure these open source coders can actually read the internet. And here we go. I don't know what's happening here, but it seems to be answering. Okay, so it seems to have given me a single piece of Python code, explanation and usage, but I can't seem to execute it anywhere. I can't understand how to do it. Let's go over here and we can see here we've got a code browser and also what looks like a Visual Studio Code icon. So let's try installing Tabby inside VS Code and see if we can get it to work properly there. And now look at this. So it tells me to set up the Tabby server. Well, I've done that. Connect to the server. So let's do this, and that will be localhost:8080. Okay, we seem to be connected. So we've got code completion, we've got chat, and we've got commands as well and keyboard shortcuts. Let's mark that all as done and get started. So I've created a folder called Tabby GPT image, and now I'm going to load up Tabby from my list of different extensions. Okay, this is all looking pretty good. So let's go ahead and see if we can create something. Let's again paste in that same prompt and hit enter and see what's going to happen. Okay, we can't seem to get anywhere at the moment. It's just saying the code I provided is a Python script, and that's all we've got. No code generated over here. Now, I have to say, I know that Tabby is less powered than my original Zed coder because I'm using Qwen and very local models. So let's go into settings. And here under system, we can see that we're using Star Coder, Qwen, and we haven't got an embedding model at the moment. So I'm going to say right now, it's a cross to Tabby for creating a full GPT-4o image generation app because it can only use local models, at least to my knowledge anyway. It's very techie and command line based. Although saying that, if you can get over all of that and install a Docker instance, I think you have superpowers. One thing I also noticed, despite being free and open source, is there is a subscription page here with the ability to paste in a license key. So it looks like you can actually pay $19 a month or more if you actually want to use Tabby professionally. So a little bit harder than Zed to install and get up and running. And once I had it working inside my browser, I suddenly had to install an extension in VS Code. This is not one that's easy to get going, but I'm happy to take a deeper dive in the future. If you think Tabby is worth looking into further, let me know in the comments down below. And let's get on to AI coding tool number 3 that is free and open source. Phew, after all that, let's go into the Void, the open source AI code editor. Void is open source, and it's they're actually calling it a cursor alternative. Write code with the best AI tools, use any model, retain full control over your data. Okay, this sounds promising. So let's click get access and download for my Mac. As you'll see, it's also available on Windows. And I think it's installed, so welcome to Void. This is cool. Okay, let's click get started. Model preferences, intelligent, private or affordable. Unlike Zed or Tabby, where they throw you in at the deep end and you have to figure it out, Void seems to have a bit of an onboarding process. Well, let's give it a fighting chance. Obviously, private could be locally hosted stuff. I'm going to go for intelligent. Okay, again, choose a provider. This is really cool. Now, I can just simply go with Anthropic like I did with Zed and paste in my Anthropic API key. Now, luckily, I've still got the same key that I can just paste in here and click next to. Okay, settings and themes. We can transfer in themes from VS Code, from Cursor or Windsurf. That's a pretty nice touch. Let's just enter the Void. Ooh, I love this. Let's make this big. This is nice. Like the logo, like the look. It's very familiar. It's got a chat over here. I wonder if this is going to be the charm. let's give it a test and create that GPT-4o image generation app again. Okay, before we get started, I'm just allowing it to access a folder called void GPT image, and now we can paste in our prompt. Now you'll see it's the same as before. I've got create a simple web app with the API docs pasted in, not a link, because I don't know if void can access the internet. Thinking has been disabled. We're on Claude 3.7 Sonnet latest, just the same as Zed, so no unfair advantages. But look at this, agent. We've also got chat and gather, discover relevant files. This is very Cursor-esque in its layout. I'm liking this, and it's free. Okay, let's get on and start creating and see what happens. Okay, it says I'll help you create that web application. It's inspecting the folder. It's creating an index file, which I can approve, just like I could in Cursor and Windsurf. Again, I can tick auto approve, so let's do that for the rest of the app creation. Now it's going to go ahead and create everything on automation. I've got to say, it's very zippy and fast. I'm actually kind of thinking, if the result is good, why would you actually use Cursor or Windsurf when this is free and seems to be the same and you can bring in your API keys? Okay, and here we go. The code is being written in front of my eyes. Let's just make this chat box a little smaller now so we can see what's going on. And yeah, it's all going through the ability to keep or reject changes. It's editing each file, agentically working through on this. Wow. Okay, it seems to have finished. Okay, I've created everything. Look at this. It's told me what it's done, given me the technical details. How to use the application, just open Index in your browser. Brilliant, that's easy, let's try it. Okay, so here it is, and it looks fairly similar to my Zed creation, but that would make sense as we're using exactly the same AI model. Let's choose an image, let's grab that one of me from earlier on, loads it in, and again, we can choose different styles. Let's go for an anime mic, and again, I'll paste in my OpenAI API key. And yes, let's open it in a new window. This is the anime version of me. Rather charming, isn't it? So it works. My AI image transformer did work in Void and in Zed. I couldn't quite get it to work inside Tabby. But here are the final thoughts. If you want simplistic code editing with single file-by-file ability to edit, then you're going to want Zed. It's simple, it's free, it really is open source, and you can bring API keys from pretty much anywhere. So whether that's DeepSeek, Olama, or Claude, or even the latest ChatGPT models, you can do it inside Zed. Tabby, I would say, is more for the power user and someone who really values their privacy, because you can spin this up on your own home server using Docker and even using your NVIDIA GPU to generate code. All the models can be downloaded directly to your server, whether that's in your business or at home, and everything runs without accessing the cloud once. But Tabby is a lot more technical, and you can stumble over things if you don't know what you're doing. I hope this is proving really handy to you. Remember to throw the like and subscribe to my channel for more. And then finally, in my opinion, there is the winner here, and that has to be Void. Firstly, because when you open it up, it's very familiar. It looks just like any other AI no-code editor you can imagine. It looks like Cursor, Windsurf. The fact that it's agentic and you can bring your API keys and there's no charge, it's completely free, Void is really winning, in my opinion. Thank you, Zapier, for partnering up with me and allowing me to bring this video to you. Make sure to check them out and support them as they support me. The link is down below in the description. And let me know what you thought about these free and open source AI code editors. What's the winner in your opinion? And did I miss one out? Let me know in the comments down below. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.